According to reports, an adult friend of the victim came to the school and gave the little boy $120. The adult friend placed the money carefully inside the boy's jacket and then placed the jacket in his bag. Apparently, the four-year-old classmate was watching and pounced on an opportunity to take the money. She then proceeded to a supermarket and spent some of that money. Little did she know she was being watched by another student. Principal of the Seventh-day Adventist School, Cyrus Sipal, weighed in on the matter, saying that parents are not always the ones at fault. He says a number of factors could contribute to such behavior, even at such a tender age, like peer influence, television, and even deprivation.
What you may find is that with the problem that we face with the financial crisis on the island, this too may be affecting children that we do not know. Maybe affecting them, because you will find that it is unfortunate that, let us say, there is a set of children. You have a set of children in the class. They are doing very well. They have the finances. The parents give them all what they need. And then you have a few in the class who may not have what they need, or maybe what they want. And then they are being influenced by seeing what the others are having, and then they now will be tempted to want to get it by other means. And
the four-year-old perpetrator, when questioned, denied taking the money. However, after continual probing by the authorities, she finally confessed to the offense, saying that she wanted the money and so she took it. Mr. Sipal observed that in some cases, children commit the offense out of sympathy for underprivileged parents.
I had this student before, some years ago. And then that the child, that's at a secondary school, and the child was involved in a similar incident. And you know what the child said? The child was helping the parent. The child was feeling sorry for the parent who just did not have the means. And in the process, the child did not want to steal. The child did not want to take somebody else's thing. But the child was feeling sorry for the parent. And in the process, the child then took the item that was not his and then felt that this is where I can reward my parent. But then it is something that is bad.
Mr. Sipal deems it imperative that children ought to be made to understand the seriousness of taking something that does not belong to them. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.